Good evening. I'm Bill Shelton, and this is Hillier Memorial Christian Church. I'm at the organ console again in the sanctuary here for the fourth installment of Tuesdays at the Hillier Organ, and I'm glad that you can join us if you're watching live or watching later. This will be on the church Facebook page and on the church website. We have now gotten through the somber music of Lent and can play some celebratory Eastertide music. As Sarah mentioned in the prayer session this morning, Easter isn't just one Sunday, but a whole season in the church of seven Sundays. So we'll be getting in some more festive and celebratory music. And I'm going to start with a piece that we've had as the prelude or postlude at our Easter services in the past year when we had brass. I'm going to try to render it on its original keyboard in that version. It's a piece by Siegfried Karg Ehlert, who's a German composer who wrote this as one of a set of 33 compositions in the style of or in tribute to other composers from all periods. Palestrina to Schoenberg, and this one is in the style of Handel. So this is Praise the Lord with drums and cymbals. We don't have any drums or cymbals, but as I had mentioned to you earlier in the week, if you have something to percuss along with, feel free. This is Praise the Lord by Karg Ehlert.
Thank you.
with many crowns. Hopefully you can find the four verses. They're in your chalice hymnal number 234 or in the program that I posted on the Facebook page. So please join in if you can. Crown with many crowns.
Thank you.
request several weeks ago when I first started these for all creatures of our God and King. And I've been putting it off because you're not supposed to sing Alleluias during Lent, but now we can. So, we're the Hugheses up in the mountains. All creatures of our God and King. This is a setting by David H. Hegarty. It's also known as simply pièce d'orgue, or organ piece, but I think Fantasia is a little more suitable to it. It's sort of got a toccata style at the beginning and the end, and in the middle part's a five-voice contrapuntal section that I think is quite interesting, and I hope you'll like this work of Bach in G major. Thank you. brings us to our last piece, which is one of the six symphonies for organ written by Louis Vierne. And Vierne, if you are not familiar with him, is another in a great pantheon, really, of great French Romantic period, 19th century organists and composers who wrote some really great works for the organs of France, Paris and France, and which I will try to render here. Vierne, I think, had such many of them had interesting lives, but Vierne overcame great adversity in his life. He lost his brother and son in battle in World War I. He was born with congenital cataracts and nearly blind throughout his life, and almost completely blind as his life went on. He was in an accident in which his leg was badly broken, and he had to relearn to use it and play the pedals of the pieces. Was organist at Notre Dame Cathedral, and it was under repair much of the time he was there. But Vierne wrote some great organ music. The symphony, the first symphony, I'm just going to do the last two movements of it. The first, I think, a serene but sort of longing, soft movement leading up to a triumphant, joyful finale. I need to do a little bit of setup here. Just for this piece, only having four generals. This is what comes with the territory. thank you for listening in. Hope you enjoyed it. And I look forward to seeing you next week, second week of Easter tide. Then take care and may God bless you.